أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Again, I'm here to congratulate all those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favor them among billions of Muslims, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invited them to visit his house. Today, again, we want to find the best way to prepare ourselves to achieve the best of our Hajj. The next point I would like to add today is, I want to feel the need of Hajj. I should feel it in my heart that I am full of sins. I am sinful. I am in trouble. I am looking forward to clean myself. I am not ready. I am not ready to meet Allah. If I die tonight, I will be in trouble. But once I intended to go to Hajj to clean myself, and Allah will look at my heart to see the sincerity, once I have this intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward me the full Hajj, even if I can't finish the Hajj. Now I need, again and again, I'm asking you to remember the need of Hajj. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was in need to go to Haram to do Hajj. So ourselves, we need to feel this need of Hajj as the person who has a heart failure and he's about to die and there is no any solution for him. Yet a doctor told him, we booked an operation for you in London to have a heart transplantation. Look how much excitation this man will have, how much he's looking forward to go to London, to see London, to be busy with the sightseeing in London. Never. He's looking when he will be in the theater to have the operation, to have the life, a new life again. This is what we should do. We should look forward to go to see Allah, to meet Allah, to have our purification, to have a new person, to start a new record, to be a new born again. Remember that shaitan will come to let us busy with Mecca, with Kaaba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. They should worship the Lord of Kaaba, not to worship Kaaba. Be careful, shaitan, never despair. Even if you want to be the best person ever on Arafah day, he doesn't want you to get the benefit, the mercy, the forgiveness, the blessings in Hajj. Be careful, brothers and sisters. This is what I want you to feel the need. I am going to Haram. I am looking forward to the blessings and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next is what? Preparation. Usually the doctors, the agents, they ask you to prepare yourself. Brothers, walk a bit. Try to train yourself, because lots of walking in Mecca. And brothers who have diabetes, and this is fair enough. But before of all of that, you need to prepare yourself for the main task you need to practice in Hajj. Is what? To guard your tongue. مَنْ حَجَّ فَلَمْ يَرْفُثْ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ رَجَعَ كَيَوْمْ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ. Don't forget this hadith. Whoever go to Hajj and guard his tongue, no argument, no talk, no chatting, no backbiting, no all of that. And this will never happen in Mecca unless you train yourself here. From now on, if you have 2 weeks until Hajj, 3 weeks, whatever, you train your tongue only dhikr. We'll come to this point that Hajj is dhikr. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that مَا جُعِلَ الطَّوَافِ وَالسَّعِي بَيْنَ الصَّفَ وَالْمَرْوَةِ وَرَمْيَ الْجِمَارِ إِلَّا لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. This ibadat to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِ. Even salah was prescribed upon us to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the main is to train your tongue. ذكر استغفار تسبيح لا إله إلا الله سبحان الله الله أكبر لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. From now on, anyone want to talk to you, train yourself, don't argue. Lower your voice, try to guard your tongue. This is a way to prepare yourself, prepare your heart. No envy, no jealous, no greed, no hatering. Only you love your brothers. You're going to go from now, from here, you're going to meet around 200 nationalities. Different race, different color, different tongue, different. You are coming from London. Be careful, shaitan will plant something in your heart. The pride. I am from London. These people from, I don't know. Remember, those people, they spend decades, maybe 30, 40, 50 years, they sacrificed their life. They never enjoyed their life to save money, pence by pence. Subhanallah, just to perform Hajj. Yourself here, it might be easy for you, but those people, they put lots of efforts much better than you. Don't ever say, I am from London. Don't ever look down at any one of them. Once you feel this in your heart, you spoil your Hajj. Your Hajj is void. You nullify your Hajj. Finished. Always look up at everyone. Believe that I am the worst person in Hajj. And this is what Ata ibn Rabah, Tabi'i, Al-Hasan al-Basri, all these Tabi'in, they used to think that I am the worst person in Hajj. Always look at these people that they are much better than me. Abu Sufyan, the master of Mecca, the top person in Mecca. When he became Muslim, he looked at Bilal and he looked up at him and he said, Bilal, you are much better than me. Bilal, a slave. He was a slave in Mecca. He was tortured in Mecca from the masters of Quraysh the Kuffar. But when Abu Sufyan became Muslim, he realized that Bilal is much better than him because Allah blessed him, Allah guided him before him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised Bilal much better than Abu Sufyan. This is what we should feel, that I'm coming from London, but I am the worst person. I don't know. Maybe anyone, I can see that he's harmful. Maybe he's the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all hujjaj because of him. You don't know. Umar ibn al-Khattab, Ali ibn Abi Talib, they were among Sahaba, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that very soon Uwais al-Qarni is coming from Yemen. If you see him, ask him to make dua for you. Every year they asking delegation coming from Yemen, is there any one of you called Uwais? No, until the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, until Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu passed away. In Khilafat Umar, Uwais al-Qarni came and they asked the delegation from Yemen, do you have anyone called Uwais? They said, yeah, there was a slave, a servant. He's outside Mecca. We left him behind to look after our camels. Yes, his name is Uwais. They ran and raced to him. Is your name Uwais? Yes, yes. Please make dua for us. Leave me alone. Who are you? I am Umar ibn al-Khattab. Oh, Khalifa. Said, don't worry. Ali ibn Abi Talib, yeah, subhanAllah. No. We ask you, we've been commanded to ask you to make dua for us. You don't know who is in Hajj. Allah will accept his dua. Look up at everyone. Look at everyone's ask and beg their dua for you. Don't ever think that you're coming from London. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clean our heart before we go to Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to take out the pride, take out the greed, take out whatever shaitan he plant, take out all these negatives and prepare our heart with the humbleness, with the khushu'. Then we can get the best out of our Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us, brothers and sisters, Hajj mabrur. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all our brothers and sisters who are going for Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and give them tawfiq and grant them Hajj mabrur. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد
والحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear brothers and sisters, pilgrims, today after our preparation, now we want to set off, want to leave home, going for Hajj. Remember, the trip of Hajj remind us the trip for the hereafter. We start our hereafter with what? Once we die, we get the ghusl, kafan, then we start to go waiting for the hereafter, waiting for the resurrection, going with our heart, with our amal, same. We do ghusl for Hajj, we put ihram, which very most likely like kafan. Our traveling for Hajj, like same traveling for the hereafter, we leave our family, we leave our children, we leave our business, we leave our friends, we leave everything. Then what we do? We go there with the heart, remind us. Same in the hereafter, nothing will help except those will come with sound heart. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. None will be successful, will be saved in the hereafter except those will come stand before Allah with a sound heart. Same, we go for tawaf. Tawaf remind us in the hereafter. When people go around looking for someone to do intercession for them, going to this prophet or that prophet, no one will help except when you have target, you target Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who will help you. You go and pray behind Maqam Ibrahim, remind you the hereafter that nothing will help you except the millat Ibrahim, thumma awhayna ilayka an ittabi' millat Ibrahim hanifa wama kana min al-mushrikeen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to follow the millah, the deen of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This is the only way to be successful in the hereafter. Same, the trip of Hajj will remind us. Sa'i, when we do sa'i in Mecca, again between Safa and Marwa, remind us. Hajar, she was looking for what? For Rahma, for Ismail. Again, we looking again for the same rahmah, which is going to help us. Nothing will help us in the hereafter except rahmat Allah Azza wa Jal. Zamzam, when we drink from Zamzam, remind us Hawd al-Kawthar. When we go there, we find the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam feeding Muslims from Hawd al-Kawthar. If you look and in your mind, in your heart, that I'm here now, this trip of Hajj remind me the trip in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the mercy, the forgiveness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us successful Hajj inshallah. Now I'm coming to set off. Before the miqat, I have to put on ihram. If you go to visit, if you've been invited to a king or a queen, or their protocol will tell you, you come at that time. You will be waiting area at that time. You will wait here. You have to sit at that seat. You have to wear that. You have to say that. There is a time to talk. There is a way to talk. All these protocols just to see someone here in dunya. What about you going to go to meet king of the king of the kings, Malik al-Muluk, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the universe? He told you there is a miqat, there is a border, Don't go beyond that before the ihram. Prepare yourself. Take out all your clothes. Put only two pieces. Ihram. But this is ihram of the body. Remember, as we said, we want to do Hajj with our heart. Do ihram for the heart. How to do ihram for my heart? Take out all the pride. Take out the arrogance. Take out hatred, the greed, the envy, the jealousy. This is the ihram of heart. Clean your heart with what? With tawbah. Tawbah. As you do shower to clean your body, you need tawbah to clean your heart. Look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Allah loves those who repent to Allah. Why? Because they clean their heart. And those who do tahara for the body, purification. So you need to do inside purification as you do outside purification. Then you put on the ihram. Ihram comes from the word called haram. Like you do takbirat ihram in salah. I'm here, I say Allahu Akbar. From now on, there is something, ihram come from haram, word called haram. Means once I say Allahu Akbar, many things will become haram. I can't eat, I can't talk, I can't drink, I can't walk. All this because I'm after takbirat al-ihram. Same, when I put on my ihram for Hajj, from now on, some actions I can't do. Why? Because it's become forbidden, prohibited from now on until I finish my Umrah or Hajj. After I put on the ihram, as I said, ihram for the body, ihram for the heart, at the miqat. Miqat is not some border like this. I say, okay, labbaik Allahumma. No, I want to get ready. I am now coming to the haram. Mentally, spiritually, I am ready. I am ready to cross the border with ihram status, body-wise, spiritual-wise, my heart is ready. Then, لبيك اللهم لبيك. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خير الحج العج والثج. The best actions in Hajj is العج, come from عجيج. Louder voice. لبيك اللهم لبيك. Don't feel shame. Raise your voice. Jibreel alayhi salam, he came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Mur ashabak, command your companions to shout with لبيك اللهم لبيك. لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك. لا شريك لك. You say it with your tongue, but you understand the meaning. You reflect the meaning. Get it with your heart. Talbiyah. It's not a nasheed. You enjoy it with people. لبيك اللهم لبيك. You enjoy it. It is not. It is a word of tawheed. It is tawheed. Ya Allah, you call me, I'm here to respond to your call. Ya Allah, I responded to many of my boss, my managers, my directors. Whenever they call me, I said, I'm here, I'm coming. I respond to their call. I fulfill all the duties towards them. Ya Allah, now you call me, Ya Allah. All myself, all my body, my heart, my spirit, my soul, all of us, we submit. I submit myself to you. Ya Allah, labbaik Allahumma labbaik. You say it twice. Labbaik come from the lub. Lub is the root of your heart. Your inside. Labbaik. All myself. Submit myself to you, Allah. Labbaik la sharika laka labbaik. I'm responding to you with a full of tawheed. No sharik, no association, nothing in my heart, no wife, no children, no business, no wealth, nothing apart of Allah, I want to please Allah. I am here to submit myself to respond to the call of Allah. I am here. Ya Allah, what you want me to do? And remember, all actions of Hajj is Amr Tawqifi. There is no thinking. Don't think why I'm doing this, why I'm doing that. Sami'na wa ata'na. Do this. I am doing it. Do that. I will do. This is Sami'na wa ata'na. And again, if you are really happy to submit yourself and to do everything which is meaningless, we don't know why I'm doing that. Just to give you the message. If you are really sincerely submit yourself and you listen to all the commands without thinking, what about the meaningful commands when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, be truthful? Meaningful, we know what's the benefit of truthfulness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a sincere Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to have the perfect ihram, body-wise and the heart ihram. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.